My partner and I stand in affirmation that the work of William Shakespeare should be accredited to Edward de Vere. After hearing what I've said, I hope you stand with us. I will break down what we believe in three main contentions. Contention one, the brain of Edward de Vere. He was a very intelligent man, and he graduated from Cambridge University at only age 14 and became a Master of Arts around age 16. As well as arts, de Vere studied law at Gray's Inn. He put his education towards writing to the loyal courts, which required a prerequisite of education that de Vere possessed. Our second contention might be one of our strongest, the pieces of work from not only Shakespeare, but de Vere as well. I would like to first point out that, however, that during the Renaissance period in England, a powerful stigma was attached to the publication of poetry and drama by courtiers. The use of pseudonyms and other forms of veiled publication was very common due to the stigma associated with print publication of controversial material. It constituted a political risk. Shakespeare's plays and poetry should show that the author had specific knowledge of works of literature prominent to the Elizabeth court, which de Vere had intimate knowledge of. For example, Venus and Adonis, the first work to have the name William Shakespeare on it. It's dedicated to the third Earl of Southampton, to whom Oxford's daughter was then engaged to. Edward de Vere and William Shakespeare directed and acted in plays around the same time. The only difference was de Vere managed his acting troupe called Oxford Boys. De Vere was also known to travel to Italy in the 1570s, giving him ideal information and a knowledge about Venice for Shakespeare's pieces, Merchant of Venice and Othello. A big tie is the connection between de Vere's life and the play Hamlet. Many believe Hamlet was a parody version of an autobiography for Edward de Vere. There's a line in the play that says, "Young man falling out at tennis." It's believed to be a reference to de Vere due to a notorious tennis court squabble with Sidney. Also in the play is a character, Polonaise. It's to believe that the character represents de Vere's father-in-law, William Cecil. Only someone with great knowledge of the Lord could have written and portrayed him correctly. In the play, Prince Hall plays practical jokes on ill-fated travelers like de Vere did in real life in 1573. And moving on to poetry that de Vere truly wrote, there's a specific one called Anne the Basor's Echo. Anne represents the Dark Lady who appears in Shakespeare's sonnets. Finally, our last contention is focused on Shakespeare's life and afterlife. Coincidentally, at court, de Vere's nickname was Spear Shaker. He was given the name because of his abilities at tournaments and because of his coat of arms. His coat of arms featured a lion brandishing a spear. Shakespeare's will containing contents from his entire life had no mention of books, manuscripts, desks, shelves, pens, papers, or anything that correlates to a literacy interest. As well as with any signature ever found from Shakespeare, are all almost illegible. All six are formed differently as well. And finally, in a time period where eulogies were copious, Shakespeare did not even have one. After hearing everything I've just mentioned, I hope you can stand in affirmation with my partner and I. The accreditation of William Shakespeare's work truly belongs to Edward de Vere.
Okay, so you said he had good education to be a lawyer, but if he did, why didn't he claim it?
I didn't say he had good education to be a lawyer.
Well, he had good education.
He said that.
Yeah, but why didn't he claim the phrase that he was?
Because, like I mentioned in the beginning, it was like what they were writing, like what they're actually writing about, it was very controversial to the political views back then. So using pseudonyms, like male publication, was very common for not only him, but like other.
So how does De Vere know all this like knowledge coming to the law school? Like, so he has like a lot of knowledge. How does he know all this? Coming from law school, not like literature.
I don't know what you mean by that. But he learned a lot of what he knows, obviously, from being in school at like Cambridge and in high school. He just went to law because it's like that law school just because he wanted to study law.
So do you have physical?
I have sources. If you want my sources? I don't know what physical. I have my sources if you want them.
Okay.
I believe that Shakespeare is the real author of these poems, and there is many pieces of evidence to show that the true author is not Edward de Vere. My first contention is Edward de Vere died in 1604, and 15 plays were written and published after his death. For example, Macbeth, Anthony, and Cleopatra, King Lear, The Tempest, Timon of Athenos, and Henry VIII. Sonnets are still written as late as 1621, but best examples are Sonnet 37, 66, 89, and 125. Edward de Vere is based on suppositions and explorations. There were printed copies of 15 plays after Edward de Vere's death in 1604. Good evidence is that William writes the plays and his name appears on them as an author. There's books of plays and pictures with his name on it. Shakespeare wrote several comedies during his early period. For example, A Midsummer's Night Dream. William Shakespeare's first play were mostly histories written in the early 1590s, such as Romeo and Juliet. Also Shakespeare was able to attract the attention of Henry Wriothesley in the Earl of Southampton, to whom he dedicated his first, second published poems. For example, Venus and Adonis and The Rape of the Priest. By 1599, William Shakespeare had his own business partner and they built their own theater on the south bank of famous river called the Boyne. Also, by 1597, 15 of the plays were written by William Shakespeare and were published. Shakespeare, final period, wrote the tragic comedies, for example, The Winter's Tale and The Tempest. My second contention is that he had a good education for his time, attending a local grammar school giving him a grounding in the Latin classics of British and literature. Scholars summarize that Shakespeare attended the King's New School in Stratford, which taught reading, writing, and the classics. Civil records show that Shakespeare attended his new, or civil records show that at his time he purchased a second largest house in Stratford and called Newhouse for his family. He took a four-day ride by horse from Stratford to London, so it's believed that Shakespeare spent most of his time in city writing and acting, and came home once a year during 40-day Lenten period when theaters were closed. He became an entrepreneur as well as an artist, and scholars believe these investments gave him time to write. He has been placed on interpreting. William Shakespeare's plays, early plays, were written in conventional style, elaborate metaphors, and rhetorical phrases. Shakespeare primarily used metrical pattern consisting of lines of unrhymed iambic pentameter and lay verses to compose his plays. My third contention is that he was an actor and acted his own plays. His name appears on the books. He was proud of what he wrote and wanted to be known. In 1594, William Shakespeare was performed in acting company of Lord Chamberlain's men. His plays were collaborations. Written records give indication of the way in which Shakespeare's life molded his artistry. All that can be deduced is that over the course of 20 years, Shakespeare wrote plays that capture a complete range of human emotion and conflict. Known throughout the world, the works of William Shakespeare have been performed in countless hamlets, villages, cities, and metropolises for more than 400 years. Two primary sources of his work are plays, poems, and sonnets, official documentary, such as church court records. By 1592, there is evidence that William Shakespeare earned a living as an actor and playwright in London and had several plays produced. From all accounts, the King's Men company were very popular, and records show that Shakespeare has works published in popular literature. And by 1597, 15 of the 37 plays written by William Shakespeare and were published. And you guys said that he went to
law school, but his uncle also taught law, and that's the school that he went to, and his uncle was his teacher. And Shakespeare also attended Stratford in school. He was in Stratford. So,
when Edward de Vere died, that his stories were published later?
Yeah.
Well, you said that he died in 1504 and that he couldn't publish these pieces at work. But Sir, Edmund K. Chambers agrees that the diggings of Shakespeare's final plays are sketchy but at best.
But he died in 1604, not 1604.
Oh. Okay, but even at that, like, when people, like, even artists today, how they create songs, and then, like, later on, like, say, like, they died, and then later on, they still can kick out those songs, but you can still have those papers still published, even if you're dead.
But Shakespeare's name was written on it.
Okay. Another reason why I'm saying, say if you turn in a paper and I write my name on it and say that's my paper, that's not really my paper. You can always put names on papers, but it's not your actual paper.
But it was just handwriting.
But, okay, going back to his handwriting, they were found only like five or six sketchy handwritings. They weren't actually like the same signature each time, and it wasn't really like the same, I guess, spelled differently each way.
So five out of the 37 things were sketchy.
Were written sketchy due to William?
Yeah, there's only five.
So you just said that William Shakespeare's plays were sketchy.
No, what I meant was that there's only five out of 37, which makes him have more plays written than anything.
Can you explain why his names are always written differently? They spell differently.
Well, okay, for example, I write my name differently in always, like.
But do you spell it wrong?
No. But did it say that his name was spelled wrong?
Yes, it did.
So what if Edward de Vere put his name as
well? But this is about Edward de Vere. It's about William Shakespeare. Or are you supposed to see his name differently and spelled differently?
Time.
Thank you.
Affirmative rebuttal? Affirmative rebuttal? No. That's our second speaker. You've already spoken. You delivered the first affirmative, right?
Yeah.
Our second affirmative rebuttal speech. You're hearing from our second speaker? Second speakers?
Wait. So wait, who's the conclusion then?
You all have a conclusion coming in. Check your sheet. Second affirmative?
The only thing that my opponent had to really say about our, I guess, what we have,
what we said,
was pretty much just about his education. That was pretty much all that they got to. Saying that he didn't really have, but his education, as education wasn't related to a writing education at all. But even coming with that, it kind of threw me off a little bit when our own opponent kind of agreed with us about his plays being shaky and his signatures, that how they were different. She couldn't really come up with a better like explanation for it. And going back to his education, Lily, I guess you don't really learn education from like a writing education, I guess, or just specifically going to a writing class. Like, yeah, in high school, you do have an English class, like everybody. But I would say even just like from everyday life, you can learn stuff about education from English, like writing. You don't have to necessarily be learning, like I guess, have a, go to school for it. Like you don't have to, you learn it every day, you learn new words, you learn new lifestyles and stuff. So with that, it helps your writing. You can, I guess, I don't know how to say this. It makes you better, I guess. I don't know how to explain it. Like, I think the other reason why we're going at his education well, because yeah, you need to learn about writing and all this stuff. But like I said, everyday life, it helps you with that. And they couldn't tear that, they couldn't really get to the meat and bones because you, I don't know, you just don't really need to learn about it. To, like, you spell things on your own when you go, or you learn your own words and stuff like that. So, like, him going to law education wasn't bad because it kind of, if you think about it, it kind of helped him write a little bit because he had to come up with ways to talk to, like, help his case out. So he needed his, like, explainings and stuff for his cases and stuff like that. So that helped him with his writing. Because, like he said, he was a smart man. He was well educated, so it helped him think, or not help him think, it helped him write. And it made him a better writer as himself, because not only did he know like the basics of writing, he knew about like other things like us in life. Like he knew about seeing different people in the law, like in law school, like how they come about. He knew about different lifestyles and how other people live and things like that. So that helped him with his writing. And I think for our other opponents, that's kind of what helped them, or not helped them, break down our case, because you don't necessarily need to be an A-plus student in your English class in order to write a story.
Second negative speaker? Second negative speaker.
Okay, I'm the second speaker from the negative side. I'm going to present more information on our contentions, addressing the attacks from the second speaker, the affirmative speaker. William Shakespeare was in fact the true author of the plays because his name is on all the books, and why would people be giving credit to the wrong person. When in fact, wouldn't someone claim that they really wrote the plays that William Shakespeare wrote, especially Edward de Vere, knowing that he was a lawyer and he could possibly win the case for writing the plays? So, like, for our contentions, like Aaliyah mentioned earlier, in 1604, there was 15 plays that were written, published after his death. He had good education for his time. According to ShakespeareOnline.com, he went to grammar school, education, and there's lack of evidence that he didn't write the plays. According to Absolute Shakespeare, he went to school for 7 years, and his uncle was a really big part of the school he went to. He has a lot of knowledge, and he teaches Shakespeare a lot of stuff since he knew a lot. The third contention that Leah did was that he was an actor and acted in his own plays. According to Shakespeare Authorship, William Shakespeare was part of the owner of the Globe Theatre, where his acting company produced the plays that attributed to him. William wrote the plays, and Shakespeare was well known as the author. He first gained notice of his writing world in 1592 in a pamphlet by Robert Greene, which refers to him as the upstart. In 1594 and 1595, there are records of favorable reviews to Shakespeare's histories. And that's what I have.
Okay. 2 minute work session.
Are you serious?
2 minute affirmative response. Rebuild your case, restate your position.
Just the only
only thing I can think of is, the only thing that they ever tore down, like I said, was his education, the correlation between his education and him going to law school and then being regular or graduating from Cambridge. And then, but they never tore down our whole case. Like, the only thing that they ever brought up was the fact that he went, his education. That's the only thing that they brought up. They didn't tear down the fact that his will. In his will, there was no mention of anything that was literacy related. They also mentioned nothing about, they never mentioned the correlation between his life and Hamlet and how well that love related to each other. They never mentioned about how, I mean, they tried bringing up the signature thing, but it didn't really make sense. We have sources, if you guys want to look at them, about how none of them, all six of them, were completely different. They were spelled, two of them, I think, were spelled different. They were never, even, they weren't even really eligible. And then they never also, just simple, like, also coincidences of his name being, like Spear Shaker, they never really, they just, the only thing that they really had was that one thing, but,
minute negative.
Okay, so they mentioned something about Hamlet, but it also, we have evidence that Hamlet did not survive, like, through the time of it or whatever. And also, you guys mentioned how writing isn't important in schools. So if writing isn't important in schools, why are they teaching us writing? And if Shakespeare really isn't the author, why are they teaching us that Shakespeare is the author in the literature books? And like you guys also said that we have a legal document stating that Shakespeare, he wrote his own plays, and if he wrote his own plays, why would he want someone acting in his own other plays if he could act them themselves? And
we have 1 minute work time, and then we'll hear the negative block, affirmative last word. Seconds. Negative summary.
Okay, so in conclusion to Shakespeare authorship debate, Shakespeare was the real author of the plays. There's enough evidence backing up William Shakespeare, and there's lack of evidence of Edward de Vere being the true author. William Shakespeare was in the company where he performed all his plays, and why would he perform the plays and not? There is a lot of evidence that William Shakespeare was the true author of these plays. And why would, after Edward de Vere died, there was 15 plays after that, so, like, why would a dead person how could a dead person write plays after they were dead? Also, it teaches us, like, so like a literature book, why would William Shakespeare name be on it? If it wasn't him who wrote the plays, why would they not give the credibility to the other person when in fact it's a real book?
Sam? Final speech?
Okay, so now ask yourself this. Do you think history has made a mistake by giving William Shakespeare all the fame and glory when all the strings are tied to William or Edward de Vere? Edward being the most brilliant minds of the Elizabeth court to being well educated, how is it not clear that it isn't not William Shakespeare? Ronald Emmerich, a speaker from the William Shakespeare conspiracy, has said, for me, I think the most possible candidate is Edward de Vere. Defenders of the theory that de Vere authored William Shakespeare's plays assume that it was inappropriate for aristocrats to write plays for the common people. Now going back to his education, like you said, we weren't saying that it's not important to not have English class. We're saying that it's important that it made Edward de Vere look smarter by he completed all his education and then going into law school made him look really like a smarter person.
Could I please have the following students in the counseling center? Alex Blair, Paul Furtado Tom, Johnny Lopez Inguido, and Brittany Montano.
Okay, even at that, he wrote the plays before he died, so they could get published afterwards. Like, it's not like when someone dies, it's that's the end of everything that they do. And Gill's Milton, no poems, no plays, no letters exist in William Shakespeare's own handwriting. All we have is the 6 slightly shaky signatures, all spelled differently. Like I said, De Vere was the most brilliant minds of the Elizabeth court. And Ronald Emmerich, for me, he said, I think that the most possible candidate is Edward de Vere. Defenders of the theory that de Vere authored William Shakespeare's plays assume that it was inappropriate for aristocrats to write his plays for the common people. So other than that, I was saying that he probably wrote these plays and just didn't want too much fame into his work. So William Shakespeare took over for him.
Come out in front of the podium and shake each other's hands. A camaraderie of good spirit. Good debate. Give them a round of applause.